Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My beloved brothers and sisters, you look at the sacrifice of the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. He left his family, as we mentioned in an earlier episode, in Mecca, barren land, nothing to eat or drink, Allah provided for them. But they made an effort. Hajar alayha salatu wa salam, she actually ran from Safa to Marwa and so on, and mashallah, the water gushed out by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Later on, they built the Kaaba. Allah said, you announce the pilgrimage and people will come. Don't worry, we will grant it acceptance. From this we learn, when you do something for the pleasure of Allah, when you know this is correct, it's upright, it's calling towards the oneness of Allah, it's calling towards following the practice of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, doing what's right, you don't need to worry about what people think of you or how they react to you. You need to worry about whether it was right or wrong in the eyes of Allah. The rest will be done by Allah. At that particular time, there was no one to announce that pilgrimage to. And what did he do? He still announced it. Guess what? We heard it today. It was relayed to us through the generations. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, relayed it to us. And it's become compulsory and obligatory for those who are able and capable to go for the Hajj at least once in their lifetimes as Muslims, so that they can reenact what Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam did and learn the lessons and change their lives. He sacrificed for the sake of Allah. Beyond that, my brothers, my sisters, he saw a dream. And that dream, he saw that he was sacrificing his own son. According to the Islamic revelation, according to what we believe, it was the son Ismail, may peace be on him. So he told his son, I saw a dream that I was sacrificing you. The son says, well then do as you're told. Because for a prophet, a dream is actually an instruction. So subhanallah, he went forth and shaitan came to him on more than one occasion and tried to distract him. You can't follow Allah's instruction. It's going to be dangerous for you. It's going to be harmful. You're going to cause harm. You're going to do this. You're going to do that. Now, this was a prophet. We cannot just see a dream and start doing as we've dreamt. No. For us, a dream cannot be an instruction that was not already ordained by Allah. Nor can it be a prohibition that was already prohibited by Allah. We cannot bring about religion through a dream you and I are going to see now. But for a prophet of Allah, may peace be upon them all, dreams had different meanings. And this is why they relayed them to their people. The prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam relayed it to his son. The son was ready. He pelted shaitan on three occasions. Notice when people go for Hajj, they pelt shaitan also on three occasions. And they repeat it for a few days. The idea is to become conscious of the plot of the devil in your life. And when a stone is being thrown towards where the jamrah is, shaitan is not physically there. But what is within you in terms of weakness should be taken out. So when it comes to the days of Hajj, remove jealousy, number one. One pebble pelting the jealousy out. Remove your hatred. Remove your envy. Remove your love of material items. Remove your competing with everyone in materialistic things. Remove your greed and so on. Remove your anger. Remove your bad habit of pornography or gambling, whatever it may be. So that is a sacrifice. That is what you're supposed to be doing. Be conscious of it, even if you have not been for the Hajj. But try and become conscious of this plot of shaitan. Read about Hajj. Read about what's supposed to be happening in the Hajj, like some of what I've told you now. But because of all of that, Allah loved it so much. When he ultimately got to his son, and they took the son ready to fulfill the instruction of Allah, Allah replaced that son with a ram from Jannah. How? Allah knows. It was, Allah says, وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. Allah says, a massive, major, huge sacrifice. Allah has replaced this person, meaning the child, with a ram. Subhanallah, subhanallah. And Allah says, وَنَادَيْنَاهُ أَنْ يَا إِبْرَاهِيمُ قَدْ صَدَّقْتَ الرُّؤْيَا. Indeed, we called him. We said, oh Ibrahim, you have indeed fulfilled what you've seen in your dream. You are a friend of ours. Allah says, وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا. Allah has taken Ibrahim as a khalil, as a close friend. So when you sacrifice for the sake of Allah, you will always become closer to Allah. What are you ready to sacrifice? My brothers and sisters, you ready to cut off your bad habits? Your jealousy, your envy, your greed, your malice, your addiction to pornography or drugs or belittling others, you know, whatever else it may be, being a big show-off, that's also sinful. May Allah protect us. Are you ready to sacrifice? If you are, Allah will provide for you. Allah will grant you great acceptance. Let's continue with more lessons in the next episode. Until then, أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.